are two different guys, I'll get them.
You sure?
Yeah, that's fine. I'll ask them first before, you know, if they have anything.
You might be shoveling, you sure?
No. I don't think we're getting that much.
Doesn't matter, you're still gonna shovel it.
I can handle 1 to 3 inches.
Okay. All right.
Mayor Bucko, can I interrupt just before you move?
Sure.
Are you definitely going to do the two public hearings March 4th?
Yes.
So if you could just make a motion or a resolution for each and then assign a time to it?
Okay.
Whether it be 7:05, you know, however much time you think you need for each.
We could have our first one at 7:05, and first one at 7:05, and the second one at 7:30.
That is, as long as you feel that's enough discussion time.
We'll do 7:05, the amendment to stormwater.
Yeah, that's gonna be quick.
Yeah, that one's right down.
We could do 7:15 then for the.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
It's a work session that we have, that we could, okay, so we need a motion.
Yes.
Right, so.
I'll make a motion.
We'll do the stormwater at 7:05.
Need a second on that motion?
A second.
Trustee Kowa?
Yes.
Trustee Mack?
Yes.
Trustee Ladonna? Trustee Ladonna?
Yes, sorry, I've got my calendar.
And 7:15 for the bus?
7:15 for the bus.
I make a motion?
I'll second it.
Trustee Kowa?
Yes.
Trustee Mack?
Yes.
Yes, don't say my name.
Trustee Ladonna?
Yes.
So 7:05 and 7:15.
Yep.
Do we have to read the resolution for?
For what?
The DWI?
The DWI?
You should. You shortened it up.
Okay.
Your pen.
Resolution intermunicipal agreement 2019-2020, stop DWI enforcement crackdown campaign. Who made the motion on that?
Rich.
Yeah. Trustee Kowa made a motion, seconded by trustee.
Ladonna.
Ladonna, and adopted to authorize the following resolution. Whereas the Village of Washingtonville is awarded an additional not to exceed amount of $2,699.50 to support the following County of Orange stop DWI regular enforcement patrol year funding commencing on March 15th, 2019 through January 1st, 2020. Whereas Mayor Joseph Bucko is authorized to sign the intermunicipal agreement.
And we voted for it.
Okay, that was voted 4-0. Okay, what's not on the agenda are three invoices dating back. Has not been sent up to EFC for H2M Architects and Engineers. There's three invoices totaling $57,031.16. These will be sent up to EFC for reimbursement, probably looking at a week from Friday. We should be receiving $349,000 this week for Capola as well as Olympic Electric. So I'd like to, you go into the meeting tomorrow?
Why did you come up?
Oh, what was the meeting, job meeting?
It was supposed to be last week. They canceled the last minute, so three of us were standing there last week.
Okay.
And then they scheduled it for this week, and then the snow, they moved it to Wednesday, and they couldn't go on Wednesday.
That's tomorrow, Wednesday?
No, last week. Like, in other words, it's every first Tuesday in the month.
Okay.
I went there, the plumber went there, the electric guy was there.
Okay.
But nobody else was there.
Okay. Oh, wait, that's when he ran into King's Capital.
Yeah.
So, we could give me authorization, I'll send H2M a check in the amount of $57,031.16.
I'll make the motion.
I'll second it.
H2M,
question along those lines, nothing to do with this payment. Have all the vendors, including H2M, been re-approved with the new statuses?
Yes.
All of them?
Yes. Except, I believe, S&O. I think there's still questions with them. S&O is our HVAC contract. They awarded the bid $155,000, I believe.
So now the payments will be held up, as you might say?
They haven't given us any applications.
Besides that, I'm saying everybody else is 100% with the re...
Whatever I have, I know Capola has their application payment 14 that came in on Friday of last week.
I guess they're approved at the new higher level.
Oh, yes, yeah, yeah.
Okay. So we're not going to have issues with that, I'm saying. That's not going to get held up for the EDC.
Now, one other thing with the RAS pumps?
Yes.
It's not part of the project.
Right.
So the RAS pumps to install, Capola had given us a price to install. He said he would work with us. Unless it had to go up to EFC, then prices would be different because it's a whole different price structure. $43,625. These are three pumps. I think we're down to one pump right now.
Barely. I thought it was scheduled already. Didn't they come in?
Scheduled, right, but we didn't give them authorization to. I don't think they're in yet. The RAS pumps themselves were $76,000.
Yeah, but didn't get delivered yet?
I have not gone down.
The last time I saw Chris, he said it was 2 weeks, and that was probably more than 2 weeks ago.
Okay, so I'll call Chris in the morning. So, authorization for Capola to install these pumps, three pumps, totaling $43,625. That's including removal of the pumps. And I don't have anything to get them out of that building. I think they built the building around these pumps. So, do I have a motion on?
I'll make the motion.
Capola and the RAS pumps.
Yes, sir.
Trustee Kowal?
Yes.
Trustee Mack?
Yes.
Yes.
Wait till I finish.
Okay.
Shout it out.
Be the early or late.
Okay, trustee. We have public comment.
Me.
No, you gotta wait.
Calm down, calm down.
One at a time.
Yeah, one at a time. We're gonna start from the left of the room.
All right.
It'll be your right, okay? We can't have people just shouting out.
I apologize.
Okay.
You got a stopwatch? You got 3 minutes.
Is it my turn yet?
Yes, it is.
Sure, thank you. I have two things. What is with the plows that the state does? You could ask them not to use the wing plow, because that's what's knocking it onto the sidewalks. They come in afterwards, and they knock down, they're up to the curb, and then they knock down that mound that has been done. And you could say, we clean those, the kids need a safe way to get to school, you're knocking them on there, the people are working, and they can't get to it. Could you at least wait till the weekend to use your wing plow? Because there's no reason for them to use a wing plow on that. And so that's that. The other one is the roads and paving. The bids are coming out soon. Are you guys prepared or to go for the bids for the milling and stuff? Like last year, they came out, the three or four bids were out before.
Right now, we have a price from...
What is that, last year's?
My last contact with them, they were going to hold it for this year.
Oh, okay. So
too. Who's the big...
Tilcon.
Mm-hmm. And... Peckham for the building.
Okay. As long as you're not letting the bids go by.
No. When did they... Yeah, the
last year was April 1st was the first one.
The first bids came in April 1? And what we need to do, you know, I remember last year we broke the village up into really bad, we need to fix it.
You still have time, you 3 minutes.
I'll come over here and ask. I'm done.
I think there's good news. They found a manhole in the swamp.
Okay.
Okay, in Woodfield. So, breaking news. So all that swamp water was going into the manhole, finding its way down to the wastewater.
Oh. So how would they have done now to stop it?
Really, it's still frozen, so they really can't do anything, but they are going to put a riser on it.
Yeah.
To stop the water from... Now, if there's one in there, it's probably another way. So it should be interesting. JCO, I think, went out with the DPW. So that's good news. Now we just have to fix it. We need the better news.
Just have a question on something that's not on the agenda that we spoke about at last meeting. We postponed it, the Little League. Have we got any more information from that?
Did she give you the bills?
Okay. Yeah.
Because she said she...
Yeah, I did a little checking myself.
Uh-huh.
And this is the electric bills for the Woodfield. She didn't have some of the springtime, but she had from May until...
Did we get a total on it?
Well, that's the monthly average, just to get a figure.
Oh, yes. Yeah. So, $1,200 average?
Yeah, about $130, $140.
Right.
Except for August. Obviously, there was not a lot of activity in August. They used it a lot. The other thought I had, which I forgot, and actually I was going to ask Paul, but I didn't know Paul was going to be here today, is the water usage.
Oh, you are? Okay. All right.
Because I'm sure they use water there as well for the stand. So maybe Paul can give us the water usage for those months.
Mm-hmm.
And then I just did a little research. This is what the softball and the baseball get per player. It's 175. That's for the regular season. So it costs $175 a kid for the regular season. What's that?
They said 100 kids, 100 girls needed that field at $175.
Mm. That's not travel ball, that's regular.
No, but I'm just
saying.
That's
regular league. That's the springtime, not the fall. The fall is travel. Having said that, the season ends at the end of June.
Yes. So it's not even August.
No, August is the playoff in
Williams.
Yes. Okay. And July is the national playoffs, you know, like regionals.
Mm-hmm.
But the schedule ends the middle of June. Then they have like a week or two later, they'll have like an ice cream social at the field. And that's the last time they use it.
Okay. I know that they came in for a permit and will address it. I want to meet with them prior to the next meeting. Remember last month they came in with a permit from 8 in the morning to 8 at night, 7 days a week.
Right.
And that's here.
Also, I printed out, they didn't have 218s roster, but they had 217s roster of the girls' softball teams. And if you look at the names, I think there's one for Washingtonville.
It's actually March 1st, not April.
Yeah, but the season needs to start.
Yeah.
For
October 31st.
That's for 2017. That's the teams for softball. And I was able to pull up one for a travel and then the schedule that they played. And that one was Poughkeepsie versus New Windsor at Woodfield.
Well, that's because it's probably playoffs, and they have to have a neutral.
Oh, it's just the sponsors on this, not the players.
Yeah, but if you look at it, no, it says, okay. It says, New Windsor, it says New Windsor, it says, it doesn't say anything about Little League, Washingtonville.
Okay. Where's the Shake Shack?
That's the one that went in and out, and isn't that the smoothie place? It closed in like 2 weeks, Fulton Square.
Oh, I thought it was in New Windsor.
Is it?
I think there's one in Atlantic, Five Corners.
I don't know how I let that go.
Wouldn't we better be better off with Masters? Those are just sponsors.
Yeah, yeah. But if you look at the names of the teams, it'll say New Windsor on the team, not just the sponsor, the team name is New Windsor.
Well, I think we have, there was a posting yesterday, they're raising money for funds that will be cut due to lack of a concession stand. And I feel there's some phone call, it's the concession stand at Mays Field.
Yeah, not the one Woodfield.
Not the one Woodfield. So I think they need to make adjustments.
Justice notes, yeah.
But August, you know, this is interesting. I don't know what happens in August.
Yeah. That's gonna be the start of travel ball.